Well, you are some audience. Okay, so people come along here with signs, you know, people got all these signs and stuff, and you're trying to remember your chords, and you're trying to remember all the words and stuff, and your mind says, don't look at the signs. But the other half of your mind says, yeah, come on, it doesn't matter. So you look at them, and if I get it wrong, I'm so good at blaming you signs. You say, I was distracted, it's a science. I mean, here we go. I'm a teacher, please sign me for show and tell. Oh, here we go. Free massage. Okay. For that. And what we got here? Help us reveal baby gender. Hey, that's intriguing. So you know what nobody else knows, right? Okay. So we went along to this little studio in Liverpool, and we paid £5 for this little recording. And this is the song we recorded that day. Spying for the danger, spying for the land they be. Sometimes people say to me, how does a song come about? How do you write a song? What happens? I say, well, there's various ways. Sometimes it could just be like a title that you like and you work on that. Sometimes it could be a musical idea or something like that. Or sometimes it could be like a musical phrase. And then you write the song on top of that. This next song started with this musical phrase. When I call, He's a fantastic guy, and you know, without him, there wouldn't be any Beatle records, so he's so good. And so reminds me that we showed up to make that record, one of the very first recording sessions, proper sessions we had. We show up and we used to do it. John used to sing the Love Me Do line, and then he'd play the harmonica right after Love Me Do. But George Martin wanted it to come on the bar, so he wanted it to be Love Me. So he said to me in the middle of the session, he said, Paul, would you mind singing Love Me Do line? I go, no, that's okay. Like, what? You know, so then John can do that and say, okay, I'll do it. I can still hear it on the record, Love Me Do. States like Arkansas and Alabama, and we heard about all of this over in England, and I wanted to try and write a song that if it ever got back to the people going through those struggles, it might just help a little bit and give them a bit of hope. Take these broken wings. you learn to fly all your life. You're only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take peace on the light to learn to see. This moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the night of the dark black night. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. I go around the world and meet loads of people. A lot of people come up to me and say, "Hey man, you know, I tried to learn that song, Blackbird, of yours on the guitar." How many people here tried to learn Blackbird on the guitar? See? And you all got it wrong. You know, sometimes in life you're going to say something nice to someone and you think, "Oh, I'll put it off. I'll say it tomorrow, I'll say it next week, I'll see you later." And then suddenly it can be too late. And this next song was written after my dear friend John passed away. Let's hear it for John. Form of a conversation that we didn't get to have. And if I said I really knew you well, what would your answer be? If you were here today, ooh, here today, probably laugh and say that we were worlds apart. If you were here today, ooh, here today, said, what do you say that we were playing hard to get? We didn't understand a thing, but we could always sing. And what about the night we cried? Because there wasn't any reason left to keep it all inside. Never understood a word, but you were always there with a smile on. If I say I really loved you and was glad you came along, then you were here today. Ooh.